Hello everyone, in this video we'll be looking at how to draw addition polymerization. So we have previously learned that addition polymerization must occur, right, for unsaturated monomers. So only for unsaturated monomers. So that will indicate that the monomer contains the C double bond C. Okay, so one good practice is to draw the monomer in such a manner. So this monomer has 1, 2, so it's an ETH, my expensive Prada bag, and then it has a double bond, so it's an ENE, it's an etene. Okay, and sometimes we draw etene in different ways, but I will always suggest that when we talk about addition polymerization, we will draw it in this manner, like a H. Okay, so how do we then draw the polymer? So what happens in the polymerization is that the double bond over here will, the double bond that looks like this will break, and then it will open up the hands this way. So what you get is that you got a C, let's draw the H first. Okay, now there used to be this double bond over here, and this double bond breaks and then it forms on two sides. So this is one unit, and this unit will join with another unit on the side, which the same thing has happened. So we got the double bond like that, and then one of the double bond actually breaks, right, and then opens up on both sides to join together. And then over here we have three repeating units over here. We got three units, we got one unit here, two unit here, three units right over here. So this is three repeating units of the polymer. And how, you know, polymers, we go on and on and on. So what we do is that instead of drawing so many, we will just write the monomer. So the monomer looks like this with the double bond. However, the double bond will open up the double bond so that it goes on both sides, draw the bracket. And to indicate that there are many, 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 many units of it, we put an N. So the N shows that there are many units. But if I only want one repeating unit, I will draw the same thing but without the N, because the N indicates that there are many, many repeating units. So over here, no N. So this one, no N. Okay, the N means many, many repeating units. So now what we're going to do is that we'll try for another one. So since this name is etene, so the name of the polymer would therefore be polyetene. So now, let's say for example, we are given the polymer and we asked to draw the monomer. So a good way is to go from the polymer to go into the polymer structure first. So we look at this, we notice that there's one unit here, there's another unit here, and then it will probably be repeated on and on. Okay? So how do I know that this is an addition polymerization? It's because you can see, the center is all C. There's a long chain of C. That is a clue that this is an addition polymer. I repeat, the center chain is all C's. So there's no O's or anything. So this shows that this is possibly a addition polymer. Okay, so you see how I draw the brackets? So what I got is C, C, F, 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 and then bracket, bracket, and then I put an N because there's many, many. Okay, so how do I convert this polymer to the monomer? So I draw the same thing again. So I got C, C, F, 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 and remember what I told you just now, the polymer is hand stretched out like that, it goes back and join this way. So then it goes back to the double bond. Okay, so now this is the monomer. So if we look at the next example here, I'm given this. So the monomer will look, you just cancel out this, you cancel the N, you cancel the sides, and then you just draw a double bond like that. So how does that look like? Okay, how would that look like? After canceling all of that, you will get the C, C, H, C, L, H, H, and then a double bond. Okay? So then if they ask you to draw several, you just repeat it a few times like that. Okay, now the last one, maybe you can pause the video here to see whether you are able to draw the monomer. Okay, so I hope you drew the monomer already. So as what I mentioned, because this is an addition polymer, so you can just cancel the end, cancel the sides, cancel the brackets, and then just draw the double bond in. So how will it look like? It will look like this, C, double bond C, this is CH3, a H, a H, and a H. Okay, so now what's the name of this polymer? Okay, so please think about it now. You can pause the video and think about it. So over here we have 1, 2, 3 carbons. So this is a butte. Right, 3 carbons is a butte. There is a double bond, so it's an ene. So this is a butene. And if this is a butene, the polymer would just have the word poly bracket and then a butene over there. So butene, polybutene. Okay, so hope you get some practice into drawing addition polymers, and then I'll see you for the next video on condensation polymers. All right, all the best. Bye. 3, 2, 1.